Prayer is not a place to cry over your problem. Prayer is a place where you empower yourself. You get back to your root. Prayer is a place where you are empowered with a mission for which God has created you. Prayer is a place where you encounter your master and encounter the mission, the ministry for which God has dreamt and called you when you are in the womb of your mother. That's why he says, for you have hidden your face. Those who don't want to hold on to him, he just moves away. Today, why? Many people praying, no answer. They pray for themselves. They pray for their needs. Very good. Definitely he is our father. But how long a man can grow with the chocolates? So today breakfast, I will give 5 chocolates. Today lunch, we will give, lunch time, 7 chocolates. Supper, we will give 3 chocolates. Is it okay? Shall we arrange like that? Why not? Chocolate has got sugar to give the strength. Chocolate has got taste. Nice, you can enjoy. Chocolate has got nice paper color. Kala, sound will come. Why not? Sister, why not? We will order for breakfast. How many? You don't want arepapre. The Bible says, because nobody wants to rouse up themselves, take effort to hunger for him, hold on to him, the face of God is hidden. You have hidden your face, you have given us up to the power of evil spirits and acts. Do you understand where, how you fall into the hand of evil? Very clearly the word of God says, there is no one who calls upon your name, no one who rouses himself to lay hold of you. For this you have hidden your face, and you have given us up to the power of our evil acts. You may be wondering, it is an Old Testament. Who? Truth is truth, whether it is old or new. Take the book of Romans chapter 1. Verse 21 onwards. Before that, I like to give you a beautiful psalm. In Psalm 27, verse 8, My heart has heard the Lord saying to me, come and talk with me, that I may reveal the secrets to you. I heard you say, come and talk with me. And my heart responds, Lord, I am coming. Lord, I am rousing up myself. Prayer doesn't simply born from heaven to you. You have to use your knees as instruments. You have to use your hands, your voice, your cry. Call upon him. There is no one to call upon. There is no one to rouse up himself. There is no one to hold on to. Same thing St. Paul will say in the book of Philippians chapter 3. Ennai pidithu kondavare, naan pidithu kondu vil, naan selgiren. I hold on to the one who is holding me. I consider the rest, everything as rubbish. I need him. I need his kingdom. I need his power. 3 verse 10, I need the power of his resurrection. All I need is the power of the resurrection of Christ. Nothing more, nothing less. Let that become your journey. Stop crying for mercy. Start to be conscious. Are you not the temple of the Holy Spirit? Am I not living in you? 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. Don't you know that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit and the Holy Spirit lives in you? Why can't you profess that? Oh Holy Spirit, who is in me, thank you. I pray to you, cast away this evil. Oh, Holy Spirit, give me the power. I pray you fill with your power with my son, with my daughter. Let your power of glory enter into him. Lord, fill my church, fill my priest with your glory. Where are the fasting and praying souls? The word of God says, my heart has heard you say, come and talk with me. And my heart responds, Lord, I am coming. God calls up his people. That's what we read in Revelation chapter 4, verse 1. God said to John, come up. I saw a hand coming. And the Lord said, get inside my hand. Get inside my hand. Come up and I will show you. I saw a door stand up, open to heaven. And the same voice says, come up here. And I got inside. That was the experience of John. Yes. Every day presents a new opportunity to experience God and to have fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Every day gives a new opportunity to experience the Father's love. Do you want to come out of your sin? Think of the love of the Father for you. Speak of the love of Jesus for you. Remember the sacrifice your Savior has done for you. Remember how the Lord who created the whole world, the Holy Spirit, wants to make you his temple. Remember the triune God. Think of the love of the Father. Speak of the saving act of Jesus and experience the power of the Holy Spirit, fellowship. That's why St. Paul, in every one of his letters, he begins with this, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And that is what we begin in the Holy Mass. That's what we end in the Holy Mass. For many, the grace of our Lord Jesus, that is the starting point of a Mass. Mass started. The grace of our Lord, the voice, sound is heard. The grace of, Mass started. Go, 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 run, run, run. Otherwise, Father will see. Run. What a tragedy. What a tragedy. We shape our own destiny by the decisions we make every day. Wherever you are, be conscious of the Lord in you. He has found you worthy, not because of your sin, but because of his power, his love for you, his holiness. We become holy not because of ours. We are not able to, overcome our weakness. But we become holy by his holiness, by holding on to him. When we hold on to him, he gives us the power. He gives us the glory. He gives us the anointing. Yes, every day gives us that kind of, every minute become a minute of worship. Yes. Yes. Most people are looking at the hands of Jesus. Yes, not his heart and not his face. Everybody wants, kya aata hai? Oh, haath se kya aata hai? What will I get from the hand? What will I get from the hands? That hands are tied on the cross. It is bleeding. Who wants to see that bleeding hands? Everybody wants to see how much I can get out of God. It's a tragedy. Thousands and thousands are running in the name of prosperity gospel to get something out of God. Where are the people who are crying, I need you, Lord. I need your cross, Lord. I want to die like you, Lord. And I want to bring life to this world, salvation to this world. Where are the Christians? Because we don't seek him. That which is part of God doesn't become part of us. We come, with a certain weakness, we hear the word and we feel happy, we pray a little bit, go away.
My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.